हिस्टोलॉजी ऑफ गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टिनल ट्रैक्ट. इट कंटेन्स इसोफेगस, स्टमक, ड्यूओडेनम, स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन. सो हिस्टोलॉजी ऑफ द स्टमक. इट कंटेन्स अ न्यूमरस पोर इन द म्यूकोसा. So all the gastrointestinal tract, it is divided into four layer: mucosa, submucosa, muscle layer is muscularis externa, and serosa. So here we can see the stomach. In the stomach, it contains the pore. So mucosa of the stomach, it is thrown into fold. It is known as the rugae. And it is folded and it gives a velvety appearance. So here we can see the gastric pore. So this pore is lined by the columnar epithelium. And this pore, it is continuous with the gastric glands. So the gland pour their secretion through this pore. There is a numerous pore in the mucosa, and in the one pore there is a numerous gland drain into the one pore. So the glands are the simple tubular or compound tubulo alveolar gland. So the mucosa contain three layer: epithelial layer, lamina propria, and muscularis mucosa. So here is muscularis mucosa, submucosa, muscular layer, and outer serous layer. It is known as the serous or adventitia. Now the small intestine. So the small intestine, it contains the projection of the mucous membrane. Inside the lumen, it is known as the villi. So also the small intestine, the inside the mucosa and submucosa, it thrones into the fold. So the whole intestine is folded, and this fold, it is known as the wall of the Kerkering. So the villi contains the simple columnar epithelium. Here the submucosal layer is also folded. So this one is the small intestine contain the duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Now the small intestine, so jejunum and ileum, it also contains a villi. And the mucosa is folded. Large intestine. In the large intestine, there is a gastric pit and gastric gland. So these gastric pits are lined by the simple columnar epithelium. So here the mucosa is not folded. So mucosa is lined by the simple columnar epithelium. So the muscular layer. The muscular layer, it contains the inner circular layer and outer longitudinal layer. So circular layer, it contains a circular and longitudinal layer. It contains a smooth muscle. The smooth muscle, it is a spindle shape. So the inner layer is circular layer. It is a spindle shape. It contains a flat nucleus. So the muscular layer in the large intestine, it is a thin compared to the small intestine. Outer longitudinal layer in cut section, it looks like a rounded cell, and in the center there is a rounded nucleus. So outer longitudinal layer, it contains in a bundles, it's okay, thick bundle at the three place in the large intestine. It is known as the tinea coli. Longitudinal fiber forms a thick bundle as a tinea coli in the large intestine. And outer layer, it is known as the serosa that covers the intestine. It is made up of the connective tissue, and when it's covered by the peritoneum, it contains the mesothelium. So here there is a longitudinal fiber of the smooth muscle that forms the tinea coli. Here there is a muscularis mucosa. It also contains a outer longitudinal layer and inner circular layer, but it is a thin layer of muscles, thin layer of outer longitudinal and inner circular layer of muscle. So in the small intestine, this muscularis mucosa is folded and it forms a valves of Kerkeri. So here it is a folded in the duodenum, jejunum and ileum. So the mucosa and submucosa is folded. So here the first one is stomach, second one is duodenum, then small intestine and large intestine. So all these parts, and also esophagus that contains a four layer, mucosa, submucosa, muscle layer and serous layer. Mucosa of the stomach, it consists of the lining epithelium, lamina propria and muscularis mucosa. The lamina propria consists of the fiber that has a collagen fiber, reticular fiber, cell, connective tissue cells. It consists of the loose areolar tissue. And the lamina propria also consists of the gland. So all over the stomach, it contains a gland in the lamina propria. So fundus and body of the stomach, it consists of the cardiac gland or gastric gland. So these gastric glands, these are different in the cardiac and pyloric gland. So here we are drawing the cell lining of the gland. So these glands, it is lined by the various type of the cell. So near the junctions of the gastric pit and the gland, it consists of the mucous neck cell. And these are the mucus secreting cell. Then the rounded cell, it is a oxyntic cells or parietal cell. It is a oval or polyhedral with large central nucleus. It secretes the intrinsic factor and axial, and it gives this gland of the stomach a beaded appearance. So it gives a necklace type appearance. It look like a necklace. In the gastric part, fundus and body of the stomach, the pits of the gastric gland, it enters into the 1/3 of the lamina propria, 1/3 of the mucosa. And what is the difference between the gland? In the cardiac gland, fundus and body are similar, and the pyloric glands. So in the fundus and body, the gastric pit is 2/3. In the cardiac part, the gastric part is very shallow. And in the pyloric parts, the gastric pits is consist of the 2/3 of the mucosa. So the gastric glands are smaller and gastric pits are longer in pyloric plate. And in body and fundus, the gastric pits is shallow and the cardiac glands are larger. Submucosa, it consists of the loose areolar tissue with blood vessels, lymphatics and nerve plexus. So here blood vessels that lines by the simple squamous epithelium. Then the muscle layer is muscularis externa. In the intestine, whole GI tract, it consists of the outer longitudinal and inner circular layer, and also the blood vessels, lymphatics and nerves are present within the muscles. So outer longitudinal layer and inner circular layer is present. So blood vessels and nerves also present in the lamina propria. The lamina propria also consists of the loose connective tissue cells, blood vessels and lymphatics. In the muscle layer, the stomach presents one more layer, that is the oblique. It is a obliquely arranged smooth muscle along the greater curvature of the stomach. And the most mucosa of the stomach is folded and it is known as the rugae. So here we gives it appearance as a folded. So it is a highly folded, and this fold is disappear while stretching. Cells of the gastric gland is chief cells or zymogenic cell that secretes the pepsin. Another cell is oxyntic cells or parietal cell that secretes the HCl and intrinsic factor. Then the mucous neck cell that present in the upper part of the gland, that secretes the mucus, and enteroendocrine cells that secretes the gastrin, serotonin and histamine, and stem cells also present. Its number is